hey eKids, I didn't see you guys there. Welcome back to eKids at Home. We got some brand new stuff for you guys today. Starting with some words that you might know, but my special guest probably doesn't know. It's gonna be a blast. And we got a new worship song for you. So let's get started.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my tomb till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I tried to hide. It was my tomb till I met you.
Alright, eKids, welcome to Say What? This is a segment of eKids at Home where we are gonna ask random people if they know what some words mean. These are words that maybe some of you guys know, but guess who doesn't know what these words might mean? My grandma, or your mom, or your dad. Maybe Pastor Adam Weber, I don't know. There might be different people on Say What every time we do this. But today, my special guest is my grandma. There's also a grandma in our lesson today, so I thought this would be perfect. Her name is Judy, and she's like my favorite person in the world. We're gonna see if she knows what some words mean. And we've got an eKid to tell us if she gets them right. So, without further ado, have fun watching Say What! And see if you know what the words mean. Hey, Grandma, how are you?
I'm good, Hopi. How are you?
I'm awesome. I have a few questions for you, if you're ready to give me some answers.
We'll try.
You got it. What is patient?
Well, it kind of means just not getting upset or mad if something doesn't go your way right away, or if you want a candy bar and you can't have one until after dinner, then just not to get upset about it and just have a little patience and waiting, which is hard sometimes but that's what patience is.
Patience means if someone's talking and he or she says, "Patience, honey," he means like, just give me a sec because I'm talking to someone, so you have to be patient and wait.
What does it mean when people say shady?
That means, I think, when something doesn't seem quite right, when it's almost too good to be true, something's maybe going on that isn't maybe so good.
Shady means like something, like if you do something that means like you're not doing something good, dude.
What is TikTok?
TikTok? Or yes. What?
Yes, what TikTok? What is TikTok?
TikTok. Well, the only thing I can think of is a clock goes tick tock, tick tock.
You're not wrong.
I'm not sure that.
You're not wrong. That is That is the sound a clock makes, but that is not what I'm talking about.
TikTok is an app on your phone where you can dance to something on there.
What is a promise?
A promise?
Yeah.
A promise is something that you say, if you promise somebody something that you will do it, that you promise to do it and you will keep that promise.
It means like, I won't do it again and I won't. Let's say I throw something and I say I'm sorry to my mom and I said, I'm sorry, I won't do that again. That's a promise.
What does goat mean? Like when people say the goat, what does goat, G-O-A-T, stand for?
Well, I just think when you say goat, I think of a goat, the animal.
It means like if a boy comes up to me and he says, I'm the goat, dude. That means he says, I'm the greatest of all time.
Good job, Grandma. You have just been our first contestant on Say What. So thank you for playing.
Well, thanks, Hopi.
You're welcome.
God bless you.
Love you. Today we are talking about a lovely woman named Sarah.
Ooh, that sounds beautiful.
It's such a prestigious name.
Sarah.
I bet so many songs are written about the name Sarah.
Yeah.
Beautiful. She was beautiful inside too. Like the kind of person that you see them walking up to you and you just think, I am so excited to see them. They make me feel so calm and happy. And they, I mean like on the outside
that,
too.
That reminds me of, actually of eKids.
Oh,
eKids guys. Have the most pure and beautiful hearts and they say such kind things.
They do.
I wish more adults were like eKids.
Wouldn't adults be so much more fun if they were
way
kids?
Cooler. Way cooler.
I try to be a kid all the time. Sometimes people think it's weird.
I don't.
Sorry, kid. But eKids, keep being fun, okay? Keep being those fun, beautiful kids on the inside and out. So Sarah, she was about 20 years old. So that's
kind of old, kind of young still. She's like sort of a kid, but mostly a grown-up when you're 20, you would probably say.
You could be your own boss at 20, I bet.
You could. That's great. Maybe she was her own boss. Fun, exciting. She was 20 years old and she had just married a dude named Abram. So they made their own two people little family, and then God said something to her. God said, I want you to have a big, big family. How do you have a big family, Kate?
Lots of babies.
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 Aww. So she was super excited about that.
Babies smell the best.
What? That's a weird thing to say, Kate.
They do.
Do you guys think babies smell good?
Awkward.
We'll move on. So she really wanted to have a baby. Abram wanted to have babies too. They were super excited. They're gonna have a big family and fulfill what God told them, right?
Absolutely.
But one small problem. Sarah had a hard time having babies. That means like her body couldn't have babies. Sometimes that happens for moms. And it's a sad thing, you know? It's not an easy thing to go through for moms. And she couldn't have babies. She was 65 years old. So she went from being 20 years old to being 65.
That's a grandma.
Yeah, it is a grandma. Grandmas are 65 years old. Grandmas don't normally have babies either, do they? So by this time, she had pretty much given up on the dream of having a big family like God had said. And that made her sad.
I would be so sad. It would almost feel like God lied to me or forgot about me.
Oh, absolutely, Kate. That would be an awful feeling. She had to wait until she was 65, and she was kind of tired of waiting, you know? Getting impatient. Like we talked about in Say What, patience is when you're really good at waiting for something, right? I'm not very good at waiting for things. Like, you know, the worst thing to wait for is pizza. When I'm hungry and I just want a nice something in my mouth and in my belly, pizza sounds so good and I just want a bite of it, or chicken nuggets, mac and cheese, ice cream. Sounds so good.
Hope.
I just want some right now.
Hope. Snap out of it. Did you order the pizza? We got a story to tell.
Who ordered the pizza?
Forget about the pizza.
I wanted the pizza.
You'll have to be patient.
Oh, patience. Where did I go? Back to the story.
Can we get back?
It's hard to wait for things. Obviously, I don't like to wait for pizza. What? Do you guys hate waiting for stuff?
It can be so hard.
Pull my hair out hard. It is insanely hard to wait for things. But God promised them, and Sarah chose to be patient still. When she was 65, she still was patient, and she tried to believe that God would fulfill his promise.
I think I would have felt like God lied to me or he forgot about me. It's that hard.
That would be a real feeling that I'm sure she felt. And that's not a bad feeling to have, you know? Like, God knows that we're human beings and that we're gonna have feelings of being impatient and feeling like he lied to us. You know, I sometimes, when I have that feeling, feel like I can't tell God that. Because, I mean, it's kind of an ucky feeling. It's not a good feeling to have.
But it's not true.
It's not true. And no. So if we can remind ourselves that it's not true and just tell God how we're feeling. Remember, we've learned this many times, that God wants us to be honest and tell him our feelings. Make him like our best friend and just talk it out with him. And that's what Sarah and Abram did. They actually prayed together a lot. And they prayed, you know, God, how are you gonna make this promise come true, you know? Like, by this time, now fast forward even more years, Sarah was actually 90 years old.
What?
That's a little too much waiting.
That's so much waiting. Like, I can't even wait 5 minutes for a pizza.
We're talking years.
5 minutes, I can't wait.
You were talking about pizza and you couldn't wait.
I know. I don't want to think about it anymore.
Sorry.
I want it so bad. Don't do it to me, Kate. But that's, like, can you imagine how badly Sarah wanted a child? Especially when God put it in her head, you know? You're gonna have so many babies and it's gonna be the bomb. And then she's 90 years old and she hasn't even had one baby yet.
Maybe by 90 you would forget.
She didn't though. She totally didn't, and she continued to believe. But at 90, she started to doubt a little. She started to get impatient. She started to have those feelings of, God, are you lying to me? God, are you gonna back out on your promise to me? Finally, a miracle happens. And there's a baby!
Ah! This is a baby! Where did it come from?
Hope!
On two babies?
Is your name Sarah?
No!
What's going on?
Sarah has a baby! That was my baby voice. Did it sound good?
That is really unbelievable.
No, but Kate, did you like my baby voice?
Yeah, it's cute.
Yay. I thought it stunk, but that's good. Anyway, it is a miracle. Sorry. Miracle.
Did we forget that she was 90?
Actually, she was almost 100.
100?
100!
I guess grandmas and babies both nap a lot.
That's true.
So,
gosh, you'd think that's a tough work.
That's
my grandma can
a
work.
A lot of work.
I mean, grandmas are tough, but that's one tough granny. So things might not always look the way we want them to, right? Like Sarah, she wanted to have a baby when she was probably, you know, like closer to 20 years old.
Like 80 years ago.
Like a lifetime ago.
Ooh.
Heck, we don't even know how long we get to live, you know? Like, you might think that the baby's not gonna happen. She wanted it to look differently, right? But sometimes that's like God's plan all along. We want things like right now, and usually in those times, God says, just wait. He says, just wait, because I've got a better plan than you do.
Calm down.
Calm it down. He says it in the nicest way possible.
Yeah.
For me, I'm like, calm down. Calm down. But he's way nicer than that. He's like, just wait. I want to help you become patient, he says. That's, you know, that's kind of like a glow up, you know? Oh, sorry. Glow That one was so high. We can have a glow up like Sarah did. Sarah was kind of impatient, right? All of her life she wanted a baby. And by the time she was almost 100 years old, she had become patient. She had figured out how to talk to God about her doubts, about being impatient. And by the time she was 100, she had become a patient grandma. She had become a patient grandma that knew that God would fulfill his promise in his time, not hers. And that was okay. And that is Sarah's glow up. Did you actually know that God even changed Sarah's name? Her name used to be Sarai with an I at the end. But to be a symbol of her glow up, he changed her name to Sarah because Sarai means princess, okay?
Okay, but how do you glow up from a princess?
Well, because princesses can become queens. And Sarah means queen. She went from a princess to a queen. Come on, that's a glow up.
I think God did that because the queen is the mother of a castle.
Mm.
Now she had her own little prince.
Oh, that's a touching story. Makes me want to tear up a little bit. Roll the end credits.
Hope, there are so many things that are incredible, but they're so hard to wait for.
Oh, like what?
Okay, so babies, we know that.
One, babies.
Like birthday presents.
Yeah.
Or the ending in a really great book. Or like a garden.
Oh yes, because it doesn't look that good.
Forever.
When you start a garden, it looks kind of poopy. Looks like dirt.
But but they're so worth the wait.
Yeah, because they turn out beautiful.
Yeah. And God keeps his promises.
Yeah, that garden blooms in the end. That is so right, Kate. Great examples, because like, if we didn't wait for a garden, we'd never see it bloom. The blooming is so worth it. Gosh, I have a garden right at home right now, so I really needed that. Thanks, Kate, because I go out and I look at it and I'm like, why are the flowers not there yet? I'll be patient. I'll try my hardest to be patient. There are a few things that we can do when we're feeling super impatient.
Ooh.
And they're actually from the Bible. Like, the Bible can help you when you're really impatient. It talks a lot about waiting in the Bible. Did you know that?
I love it. Give me the list.
That will help us so much.
What do we do?
Okay. Step one. Tell God what you're feeling impatient about. Just tell him.
I think I'll be really good at this. Now that we've talked about it, I don't think I'll get impatient or sad or crabby or all the yucky things. I think I can be perfect at patience.
Kate, I think that it's awesome that you want to give it your best shot, you know? Like, you go for it, girl. You got it. But we can't be perfect. Because only God is perfect. Like, everyone here on earth, you know, like where we are, we weren't meant to be perfect. Like, we're not meant to be perfect right now, because like, there's sin in our world. You know, like, we're not perfect. Only God is. Only God knows everything.
I forgot about that.
Yeah, so like,
right.
If we were Check. Perfect, we would never have anything to talk to God about. Think about that. Like, if we were perfect, we would never have a relationship with God. He'd never be our best friend. And he wants us to just do our best, not try to be perfect, you know?
That makes sense.
Yeah, because I mean, he knows we're gonna mess up every now and then, and he doesn't want us to feel yucky about it. He wants us to tell him about it, and he'll forgive us. And he'll be like, you know, no problem, we'll get it next time. That's what God wants.
I love that we can just get rid of all those yucky feelings, and he actually wants to hear about it.
Yeah, he wants to be your best friend. I tell my best friend all like the yucky stuff, and then she helps me to feel better about it. So like, that's what God wants to do with us too. So you think maybe you won't try to be perfect? Like, you'll just do your best probably with being impatient. Cause I mean, sometimes you're not gonna like to wait. Sorry to tell you.
I don't love to wait still.
Yeah.
But I can try to ask for help.
You can.
I can do.
And when you mess up, you just talk to God about it. You give it another good old try. The second thing you can do when you're feeling super impatient and you just like can't stand it anymore, think of a time that God came through for you. Think of a time that you were really impatient. Like Sarah, she had her baby, right? God answered his promise to her, right? So think of a time that God did that for you. Like, maybe you were worried about not having friends and God gave you a friend. You know, it took a while, but he gave you a friend, right? Just think of something like that in your life, write it down or draw a picture of it, and let that remind you that being patient works.
So you're saying, in order to get really good at being patient,
mm-hmm.
two things. First thing, I just have to practice talking to God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I love that. I can tell him about all my yucky feelings and get rid of them.
Blech.
Number two, I get to draw. Grab a journal and just
get in there.
Sketch whatever you're feeling.
Yeah.
That sounds so easy.
It's perfect.
And none of us have to be perfect.
No.
You just draw whatever comes to you and talk to him about whatever you're thinking.
Isn't it a great plan?
I think I have a chance at being patient.
I think we all do. It sounds like a pretty bulletproof plan, right? Like, we can't lose in that plan. And we'll just get better and better at it. Every time you try it, maybe the first time you still feel impatient, but if you give it a few good tries, God will start to glow you up.
Yes!
God wants to help you become more patient. You probably can't do it on your own. We can't do like most things on our own. We have to ask God for help, and it's okay to ask for help. I ask for help all the time. And that's like what glowing up is. Like asking God to fulfill the things that he has for your life, right? He wants you to become something that he knows you can become. He knows that you can become patient instead of being like super impatient, right? So that sounds like a great plan, Kate. Thanks for helping us with that. I'm really excited to hear about how your glow ups are going, guys. Have you figured it out? Like, where are you at with it? Tell God, okay? Tell God. Tell him where you're at. Like, are you feeling like a little better about your glow up? Or have you even thought about your glow up yet? Tell him everything. He wants to be your sidekick. He loves to be on the journey with you to your glow up. See ya.
What's up, eKids? I'm so glad you're here. I get so excited to learn the Bible verse every week that sometimes I get a little impatient. I mean, I start thinking about learning a new lesson and then thinking about memorizing another verse and sending you guys eKids box that it's really hard for me to wait. That's why I'm so happy this week's lesson on Sarah teaches us the importance of being patient, because sometimes I need that reminder. Speaking of reminders, do you remember the steps you need to do to get those eKids box? Let's run through them. Step one, you have to memorize the verse. It's that simple. Step two, have a video of you reciting the verse. And step three, send that video over to your eKids coordinator through Facebook, Instagram, text message, email, whatever you like. So Hope and Kate just told us that Sarah really wanted to be a mom, but she had to wait an extremely long time. She had to wait years. Yes, years. I don't like waiting for hours, and sometimes I don't even like waiting for minutes when I really want something. So I can't imagine Sarah having to wait years, but God made her a promise, and she really wanted that child, but she was getting really old. But remember, we know God made her a promise, and we see this promise in our Bible verse for this week. God is talking to Abraham about Abraham's wife Sarah in chapter 17, verse 16. And I will bless her and give you a son from her. Yes, I will bless her richly and make her the mother of many nations. Kings of nations will be among her descendants. Wow, God really did make Sarah a big promise. I mean, not only would she become a mom, but she'd become a mother of many nations. Sarah had to be patient as God's promises came true, and they did. She went from childless to having a kid where kings of nations would be among her descendants. Talk about a glow up if I've ever seen one. Sarah had an incredible glow up, but she did have to wait on God. So this week, as you're memorizing your Bible verse, I want you to remember that God can give you your very own glow up, but you might have to be a patient waiter as his promises unfold. This week, we learned that when we're feeling really impatient about something, God wants us to talk to him. So let's take a God minute. What's a God minute? It's where we take 60 seconds and we spend time with God. So I want you to rack your brains and think about something that you're really impatient about. Do you have it? All right, spill your guts to God. Spend 60 seconds together starting now.
Don't you think, Kate? I love it. I can be patient.